Ladies and gentlemen, the session of this honorable body is about to commence. Everybody will please rise.
As the elected city vice mayor and the presiding officer, this 8th regular session is now called to order. Roll call please, Mr. Secretary.
The members of the Sangguniang Panlungsod, the Honorable Morada, Angeles, Toledo, Ghost the Second, Ronquillo, Manalo, Lina the Third, Silva,
President.
Rocoford, Umali, Makala, Loho,
President.
Recto, Makala, and the Honorable Presiding Officer, Camille Angeline M. Lopez.
Do we have a quorum?
We have a quorum.
May I request the Honorable Merlo Silva to lead the invocation and the leading of the national anthem.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Sumandali ho nating ilagay ang ating mga sarili sa presensya ng ating Panginoon Diyos. Upang sa ganoon, tayo puspusin ng kanyang banal na Espiritu. Panginoon Diyos na buhay na may gawa ng langit at lupa, kami po ay muli nagpapasalamat sa panibagong buhay na iyo pinagkaloob sa amin. Ganun din po, Panginoon Diyos, kami po ay nagpapasalamat na sa lahat po ng mga sakuna na nangyayari sa aming bansa, ang lungsod na Lipa at ang kanyang mamamayan ay nananatiling ligtas. Ganun din po, Panginoon Diyos, patnubayan mo ang bawat pamilya ng mga narinitong mga kababayan namin sa lungsod na Lipa. Ganun din, Panginoon, sa umagang ito, sana ipuspusin mo aming mga puso ng awa, pangunawa, upang sa ganoon, ang lahat ng aming pag-uusapan, pagdidesisyonan sa umagang ito ay nauukol sa kabutihan ng aming lungsod at ng kanyang mamamayan. Ito'y hinihingi namin sa pamagitan ng iyong anak ni Jesus Cristo, naghahari noot ngayon, magpasawalang hanggan. Amen. Ating aawitin ang pambansang awit ng Pilipinas.
Mga kababayan, ang pambansang awit ng Pilipinas.
Good morning po sa lahat ng members of this august body present in this session hall and also present via Google Meet. We have Concejal King Umali and Concejal Jun Gosos. Good morning po sa inyong lahat. And to all the staffs, to all the guests, and to the secretariat, good morning. So before we proceed with the privilege hour, may I recognize, please, Attorney Gali Angeles.
Magandang umaga sa mga kasama natin, sa mga bisita. Gusto ko po sana ipakilala sa inyo. We suspended already. I move to suspend the rules, Madam Chair.
Any second? Duly seconded by the majority members of the August body. Rule suspended.
Thank you, Madam Chair. May I have the privilege to introduce our new officer in charge, Chief of Police of Lipa City, in the person of Police Lieutenant Colonel Ariel B. Azurin, and we'd like to give the floor to him to at least introduce himself and his plans about over the city. Palapakan naman po natin.
Thank you very much, sir. First of all, if the Honorable Presiding Officer, the Vice Mayor, would allow me to recognize one by one the members of this honorable body, ma'am, since I've been newly assigned and designated as officer in charge of the Lipa City. Of course, the Presiding Officer, the Honorable Camille Angeline Lopez, ma'am, the Honorable Michael Gerard Morada, Honorable Galileo Angeles, sir. Yes. Honorable Jennifer Spy Toledo, ma'am. Nice meeting you. Honorable Oscar M. Gosos, the second. Oh, sorry. Honorable Riofer Nicole Ronquillo, ma'am. Honorable Venice Manalo. Honorable Miguel P. Lina, the third. Honorable Merlo P. Silva. Good morning, sir. Good morning, sir. Honorable Avior R. Ford. Sir, good morning. Honorable Ralph Peter Umali.
Good morning, po.
Yes, good morning, po, sir. Honorable Aris Makala, sir. Honorable Percival V. Loho. Sir, good morning po. And of course, our ABC President, Honorable Emmanuel Recto. And the SK Federation President, Honorable Gian Paolo Macala. Good morning, sir. Since everybody has been recognized, thank you very much. I would like to introduce, formally introduce myself. I am Police Lieutenant Colonel Ariel B. Azurin. I'm not new here in Calabar Zone since I've been assigned in all the provinces of Calabar Zone, previously assigned. But when I've been reassigned in Camp Crame in the Directorate for Personnel, when I came back here in Calabar Zone, I opted to be assigned in Batangas since I've been assigned in all the provinces except for Batangas. That's why I decided to be assigned here in Batangas. And my first assignment here in Batangas is as the Chief of Police of Tanawan City Police Station in 2021 until April of this year. So after which I've been designated as before the election, I was relieved and designated as the chief of the Provincial Investigation and Detective Management Unit of the Batangas Police Provincial Office. And fortunately, been designated as the officer in charge of Lipa City since my order was August 22, 2022. So my plan here in Lipa City in relation to the improvement or the peace and order situation is, of course, to lessen the incidence of our focus crime, the index crime, the murder, homicide, physical injury, rape, theft, robbery, special complex crime, and carnapping incidents, of course. For me to be successful in this endeavor, of course, the police of the Lipa City really needs the help and support of our local government officers in terms of logistical, of course, and yung ating importante po sa amin yung concern ng bawat community na pinapaabot sa ating mga opisyal. No? Kasi yung reporting system, so that we can address the real concern of our community here in Lipa City. Na ganun din ang ginawa ko sa Tanawan, kasama ako sa group ng mga sa community, sa mga members ng officers ng ating city. Para sa ganun, yung mga concerns po, direktang nakikita ko, or kung hindi man po, may paabot sana po sa akin ng ating mga ginagalang na member ng ating Sangguniang Panlungsod na ma-address natin, no, yung ating problema dito sa Lipa City. Wherein, the deployment or the intervention is in place naman po yan, no? All the resources has been exhausted. Nakita ko naman po na talagang yung police population po natin kasi ngayon, ratio natin is 1,000 to 1,665, no? So still with the large city as Lipa and the number of population, our number of police officers hindi po talaga sapat. And ang ginagawa po natin diyan, in-engage po natin nating mga force multipliers, the barangay BPATS, no, yung ating mga non-government organization, so that they can help, no. Importante kasi yung citizens watch na tinatawag natin. Marami tayong mga krimen na nangyayari na minsan ang mga sa barangay tanod or ating mga barangay officials na ang nakakahuli minsan, ano, kasi nga dahil sa kakulangan ng ating kapulisan. But of course hindi po yan dahilan para hindi tayo makapag-deliver ng magandang serbisyo sa community ng Lipa City. We will do our very best. Of course, exhaust namin lahat po na resources namin, even our office personnel are being utilized as firewall personnel. Pwede sabihin po ng firewall, pagka meron pong time sa duty nila na ilalabas natin sila so that they will be visible in the street, no? Especially dito sa ating poblacion area. And hopefully, and I am very optimistic that we can do a better job in keeping the peace and order situation better, no, here in Lipa City. That's all for me. Thank you very much, Ma'am Presiding Officer.
Thank you, sir. Any comments or questions? Attorney, yes, Dali Angeles, you are recognized.
Ah, Colonel. May tanong lang po ko na konti po, no?
Yes, sir.
How do you assess the peace and order situation as well as the drug cases here in Lipa?
Yes, sir. Since I've been assigned in the provincial office, the assessment po is yung ating mga drugs po dito ay usually dapo lang. No, wala tayong mga dapo lang. Dapo po yung mga ating mga nagdadala ng mga contrabands dito sa atin sa Lipa City.
Uh-huh.
But yung talagang bulto ng droga ay wala po talaga sa atin. Kumbaga, galing po sa labas. Just the same with, kasi dito po sa province ng Batangas, as per assessment din po ng ating PIDEA, no, ay wala po dito sa Batangas talaga na yung
Laboratorio.
Kumbaga, yung mga droga natin ay nanggagaling sa labas po. So, meron tayong mga drug personalities na during the assessment and the regional intelligence committee meeting po natin, ay nabobrota po, so series of surveillance and studies are being conducted. At meron nga po tayong sinerve na yesterday, no? Nag-start na rin po ako magtrabaho. Meron po tayong sinerve na SW search warrant sa isang drug personality po natin dito sa Tanawan, ay sa Lipa City, no? And he was successfully arrested naman po. Isa po pong cohort niya ang nakuha po natin. Taga-benta po ng droga niya. Mm. So, since I'm new here in Lipa City, pag-aaralan ko po ng mabuti, no, para po malinis natin ng ating bayan ng Lipa against sa drugs, no? At continuous rin po ang ating drug clearing operation and yung assessment, yung binoboard po namin yung barangay drug clearing natin na ginagawa na with the help of PIDEA and other government agencies ay binoboard po namin yon para maging drug-free ang isang barangay po.
Opo, salamat po. Doon po sa inyong community, how do you plan to closely coordinate with the barangay officials regarding the implementations of your plans and priorities in the city of Lipa?
Sir, ang gagawin po natin dyan, by priority po. Kaya nga po nag-ano tayo ng mga crime mapping, drug mapping, incidents po natin, asan yung pinaka problema natin when it comes to drug menace and criminality here in Lipa. Then yun po ang unang-una natin pupuntahan. Ako po mismo ang bababa sa barangay. Yo. So that ako po first hand, malalaman ko kung anong sitwasyon doon sa area po.
Okay. Sige. Maraming salamat po at, yes.
Honorable Merle Silva, you are recognized.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Sir, I hope that Lipa City is safe and protected under your leadership.
Yes, sir. I will assure you that, sir.
Awali may dalawang tanong, sir. Kasi ho, dito sa lungsod na Lipa, marami ho tayong mga nakakausap na nagkakaroon ng kaso all about illegal drugs. At ang sabi ho nila, wala silang dala, walang ano, at sabi ng iba, eh, meron daw hong kota lagi ang mga pulis para manghuli. At sila daw inakakasama sa kota at kuminsan daw ho ay palit ulo. Ay sabi ko nga, hey, siguro may hindi ho totoo yun. Ngayon, ito ay pagkakataon para ho siguro pasubalian ninyo or yes, ano ho ang katotohanan tungkol sa mga akusasyon ngayon.
Yes po. Although meron po kaming tinatawag na target, ang mga target namin, number of accomplishment. But ako po hindi ako particular doon. Kasi sir, meron po tayong tinatawag, we are morally obligated that those people na ikukulong natin ay totoo. Ay totoong gumagawa ng mali, totoong drug pusher, drug user, at number, members ng ating criminal groups, no? O, hindi po kaya ng konsensya ko na magkulong ng tao na inosente. O, yun po ang aking masasabi. Kaya po ako, gagawin ko yung aking trabaho. Hindi po importante sa akin ang target, but sa akin, ang importante ay yung totoong criminal ang ating ikukulong.
Thank you. Anong ibig sabihin nyo sa target? Kinakailan lagi may kota? E paano kung wala nang... Paano ho kung wala nang user, wala pa nang pusher sa Lipa? Can you attain the target?
Ah, hindi po. Katulad po, before pa, itong ating Lipa City, mga previous COPs natin, hindi naman po talaga nila namimit ang target. Even po ako noon ako'y COP ng Tanawan, hindi ko po namimit yung target talaga kasi mataas po yun. Kumbaga, yun lang po yung binibigay sa amin. Para sa ganun, meron po kaming target na of excellence po na mahuli namin yung aming mga mas marami pa. Kumbaga, totoo po yung huli natin, pero bibigyan namin kayo ng target. Para sa ganun po, magtrabaho yung ating mga polis.
Ay, akala ko higa may target. Kasi papano ko ang isang lungsod, ay ibig sabihin ho, dumami, ibig sabihin, hindi ho maganda.
Apo.
Ang pamalakad at may problema. Diga ho.
Apo.
So, siguro doon tayo sa puntos na sana mawala na ho yung target ng PNP sa Lungsod na Lipa. Meaning to say, kung mawawala yan, ibig sabihin, ang Lungsod na Lipa wala na problema sa drugs. Ano po?
Apo.
At ang isa pa po, sir.
Yes, sir.
Hindi ko malaman kung di man ho ako masyadong naniniwala sa mga TikTok. Mm. Pero ako'y may anak kong mga dalaga ay nag-aalala. Ano gawin yung katotohanan doon ho sa mga nawawala daw ho mga dalaga, nawawala ho mga bata, particular dito ho sa Bulacan, Laguna, ito ho ay laging malimit ho sa TikTok at saka sa social media. Ano ho katotohanan noon? At dito ho sa Lungsod na Lipa, ano ho ang atin hong, kung ito totoo, ano pwede hong advice na magagawa ng pulisya para sa atin ng mga kabataan na Lungsod ng Lipa?
Opo. Actually po yan, unvalidated pa po kasi yung mga yan. Unang-una, dito sa province of Batangas, wala pa naman po tayong naitatalang ganyang insidente na nawawala ng mga dalaga. No? Even yung meron akong naging kaibigan sa Tara, nagte-text nga po dahil nag-aaral yung kanyang anak daw dito sa Lipa. Baka mamaya, mga dalaga raw, baka mawala. Sabi ko, andito lang po ako, i-text nyo lang po ako, o tawagan po, ibigay nyo po yung number ko sa inyong anak. Para sa ganun po, mabigyan ko sila ng parang feeling of security po. But of course, we will do it with a job. Maging visible po ang ating mga pulis sa kalsada. No? Ang may papayo ko lang po, syempre, maging vigilant pa rin po. No? Sabi nga po, hindi naman po ang peace and order situation, hindi lang po talaga concern yan ng ating kapulisan. But of course, all the members of the community and the officers working on it. Yan lang po, sir.
Thank you and welcome to the City of Lipa. Dumasa kayo, sir. Yes. Kung anong problema ho at kailangan ng kapulisan, nandito ho. Thank you very much.
Sir. Thank you, Honorable Merlo Silva. May questions pa po? Meron pa po si Council of Your.
Okay po.
You are recognized.
Madam Chair, I would like to follow up the question of Council Merlo Silva, sir. Magandang araw po. I chair the Committee on Budget, Environment, Traffic, and Social Services. And under the Committee on Social Services, I am the one who oversees the operation of the Rehab Center of Lipa and the Bahay Pag-asa, or where the minors, those children in conflict with the law are being housed or serves as the holding area for minors.
Yes,
so, sir, how do you differentiate, a while ago, Consel Merlo reiterate the targets of the PNP with regards to different categories of crimes. Now, how do you, sir, differentiate drug users from drug pushers? And what is the PNP's priority under your leadership in Lipa with regards to users and pushers dito po sa lungsod namin?
Opo, sir. Yung sa previous administration naman po natin, meron tayong tinatawag na yung sa drug rehabilitation program po, sir, no? Doon sa mga nagiginauhuli natin ng mga drug users, no? O naman na i-differentiate natin, drug users and drug pushers. Of course, yung ating user ay talagang gumagamit lang, talagang bumibili pang gamit. Pero yung talagang pusher natin, kahit konti po yung amount niyan, once you are selling, you already selling, you are pushing drugs. Apo. Ngayon, pagdating naman po dyan, of course, ang ating priority na mahuli talaga ay yung mga sources. If I'm not mistaken po, dati nga nung time ni Lieutenant Colonel Tarazona, yung suspect nila na nagbabagsak din ng drugs dito sa Lipa ay umabot pa ang transaction hanggang doon sa Quezon City. No? Yeah, no. Kasi ayaw nilang lumapo dito dahil alam nila na baka entrapment to. Baka ito ay trabaho ng government agencies. So, ito naman po yung ating mga drug user natin, as much as possible, no? Inire-rehabilitate, we encourage them. Kaya nga po meron po tayong mga drug surrenderers na tinatawag. Para sa ganun, we give them hope, we give them chance to live a normal life. Na para sa ganun, away from drugs, no? But of course, pagka hindi pa rin sila titigil, kailangan po siguro natin na mas kamay na ikulong sila. Para sa ganun, hindi nang pamarisan. Kasi ito pong mga drug users na to ay nakaka-influence din po sa ating mga kabataan eh. Na pag gumagamit, subukan mo. Kasi po, nung ako rin po ay kabataan, meron din po nag-alok sa akin yan, tinanggihan ko. Kaibigan ko, sabi ko, sige, huwag nyo na akong idamay dyan. Kung gusto yung gumawa niyan, kung hindi ko kayo ma-influensya na huwag itigil yan, huwag nyo na ako idamay. O malaki impluwensya nila, no? Lalo na sa ngayon na nagkaroon ng pandemya at yung mga bata natin ay nandun lang sa community na hindi makalabas, walang magawang ibang bagay, hindi makapaglaro ng sports dati dahil nga sa lockdown. Ngayon po, siguro hindi na. Ang gagawin natin dyan yung mga, of course, mga program ng ating local government unit in relation to sports and activities of our minors and our, of course, mga kabataan natin with the help of our SK Federation President, no? We keep them away from illegal drugs, the use of illegal drugs and exposure of it.
Okay, sir. Salamat po. Kasi, sir, ako ay may kapatid na piskal, mag-asawa sila.
Napa.
Tapos ay minsan po, napapansin natin na sa mga information na isinasubmit ng mga kapulisan, halatang halata, siguro po hindi naman dito sa Lipa nangyayari, pero minsan po nahalata sa information na ginagawang pusher ang isang tao at hindi user na nahuli para lang po mas malakas yung kaso na isasampas sa kanila. Pangalawa po, ay dito po sa amin sa rehab center ay marami po dito, meron po kaming ilang mga drug personalities na court nag-undergo ng plea bargaining sa korte, kaya sila po ay inilipat ng korte sa aming mga rehab center. So kami po dito sa Lipa ay kaya nagtayo ng rehab center, naniniwala po kami na ito pong aming mga drug users ay mga biktima nito pong ating drug user. Biktima po nito pong illegal na droga na gumagala dito sa Lipa. Kaya siyempre ayaw naman po namin na mapagaya kami sa Maynila na nung mga panahon ng dating administrasyon ay maraming mga kababayan namin ang sa ibang lugar namatay, marami ang nakulong dahil wala naman silang kasalanan. Ay yun lang po yung aming concern dito sa Lipa. Kasi ako, I do not want to speak with the rest of the members of the Sangguniang Panlungsod, but as I am one of those who advocate the value of human rights. And yun ho yung aking ina-advocate dito sa Sangguniang Panlungsod. So, yun po ang aming pinalalakas ho namin ang aming rehab center. We are institutionalizing mechanisms para baguhin yung mga programa namin because we believe that these drug users, being lipenyo, needs to be rehabilitated and give them a chance to prove themselves to be again part of this community. So yun po yung aming pakiusap sa inyong leadership.
Yes,
dahil babantayan ho namin bilang mga kinatawan ng kababayan namin bilang mga halal na opisyal ang karapatan ng atin hong mga kababayan, bagamat sila ho ay may kasalanan ginawa dito sa aming lungsod.
Yes po. Sir, in relation naman po doon sa pagiging user ng isang drug user, no, na na-file natin yung case sa court, then nag-plea bargaining, no? Because these targets or these suspects na mga drug users and drug pushers natin, o sabihin na lang natin na drug user, dumadaan naman po sila sa talagang validation, no? Validation po ng ating mga kapulisan if really are engaged in using drugs, no? Ngayon, meron po mga iba na sabi nga, dati nag-surrender na because they admit that they've been using drugs. Then, later on, they will be caught again using drugs or in a pot session. Kaya nagpo-push through po yung case doon sa ating fiscal. Ngayon po, pagdating naman po sa user and pusher, kasi po sa amin sa PNP, we let the court decide, we let the court determine if they fall in these circumstances being presented or yung mga testimonies ng ating mga witnesses if they fall in the category of user or pusher. Pag na-determine naman po ng ating court na this one is cannot be categorized as a pusher because it seems to me that he is just a user. So i-dinadrop and close na po yung isang kaso. Kasi sineseparate po yan ngayon, hiwalay po, being user and pusher po.
Yes. Kasi during the creation of the rehab center, I was involved during that time because that was created way back 2016. 2010. Isa rin po sa mga nagiging problema ng mga drug users. Upon interview with some private rehab centers, I mean, tinatawag po tayong mga relapse. So, pag sinabi pong relapse, kahit na nirehabilitate na yung tao, nagka-problema siya, again, babalik siya, yes. Gagamit siya. These are relapse. And ito'y ginagamot pa rin ng mga private rehab centers, itong mga relapse na ito. They again undergo rehabs. So, hindi andyan ho ang ating doktor, alam niya aking sinasabi. So, hindi, sa akin talaga, hindi natin masisisi ang isang tao kung siya'y gumamit ulit. Dahil yan ay sa medical term, nag-relapse siya. Naging mahina yung kanyang kondisyon, kaya nagka-problema, bumalik sa ganito, at dapat ulit nating i-rehabilitate. So, yun po yung sa akin. Kaya po, bagamat isinasampa po natin ang kaso sa korte, yun lang po ang aking komento. Kasi, syempre, sa amin pong nagawa ho kami ng ordinance creating the rehab center of Lipa, and part of the duties of the rehab center is to to be a mediation with regards to drug cases filed in court. Ibig sabihin, tingnan nila kung ang sinampahan ng kaso ay user o pusher, at pag nakita nila na user, they meditate. Sila ay pumagitna. At
mediate.
Pumagitna at kuhanin o mag-submit ng manifestation na pwede nilang kuhanin yung nahuli at ma-rehabilitate sa aming drug facility. That was patterned in Quezon City. Yung ordinance namin na ginawa with regards to the creation of the rehab center.
Yes.
So yun lang po, para alam rin ho ninyo, sir, na ito yung mga existing ordinance namin pagdating sa rehab center. Ito yung mga facilities, ito yung mga tao na binigyan namin ng kapangyarihan para dito.
Yes po. Nakita ko po intention niya. Napakaganda po ng intention po, sir. And sa tingin po, sir, kakailanganin natin ng tulong dyan ng ating mga barangay captains, kasi po mga barangay chairman, no, kasi po since they are the chairman of the BADA, no, at sinasabi natin na nahuli na, nakalabas, nabigyan ng chance, then nagkaroon ng problema, they engage again in using drugs, then siguro if this our barangay officers or barangay chairman can monitor the activities of this sinasabi natin na bumalik sa paggamit, maybe doon po pwede na mahikahit sila na magparehab ka na, no? Kaysa mahuli ka ng pulis, makukulong ka lang, magparehab ka na. O kasi po sa atin, nandiyan naman po yung ating guideline sa batas, no? Pagka nahuli po talaga natin, ay hindi po natin pwedeng idiretso kagad sa rehabilitation, but of course, dadaan po sa due process. So yung pag-encourage sa kanila na magparehab once they were monitored using drugs again, doon po sana natin madala sa ating barangay level, sa BADAP, para sa ganun. Bago pa sila mauli, magparehab ka na. Para sa ganun, you submit yourself para sa rehabilitation.
Okay, sir, salamat po.
Apa, thank you very much, sir.
Thank you. Any other questions for sir? None? Attorney Gali, you are recognized.
Thank you very much, Lieutenant Colonel Ariel B. Asurin. Sana po ay maging masaya at makabuluhan ang inyong
pag-monitor na aming kapulisan dito sa lungsod ng Lipa. Maraming salamat po at mahingi ko po sana konting palakpak para sa ating bagong OIC. Okay, well, maraming salamat sa ating OIC Chief of Police. And ngayon naman po ay pwede pong bigyan natin ng oras naman at ang ating Deputy Chief of Police sa katauhan po ni Major Fernando. So palakpakan po natin siya at para mapakilala sarili niya.
Magandang umaga po sa ating lahat. Opo. Papakilala ko po ang aking sarili. Ano po? Ako po si Police Major Fernando Orfano Fernando. Ayun po. Tama po yung inyo narinig. Pares po ang aking pangalan at saka apelyido. Ano po? Ako po ay hindi na rin po bago dito sa Lipa. Actually po, since 2012 to 2016, dito na po ako naka-assign. When I was lieutenant. Ano po? Hindi lang po ako exposed masyado sa City Hall. Kaya po, hindi po ako masyadong na... Kasi po, kami po yung workhorse. Kami po yung nasa kalsada. Ano po? At mas madalas po kami sa kalsada. Pero... after po ng 2016, nag-chief of police din po ako ng Padre Garcia for 2 years. Ano po, 2016 to 2018. And then, provincial headquarters, nag-chief of police din po ako ng Malbar, Batangas. Apo, Malbar MPS. So, ngayon po, bumalik po ulit tayo ng Lipa as Deputy Chief of Police po ni Sir Azurin. At ako po ay nagagalak at ako po ay nandito po muli para magsilbi po sa Lipa City. Kami po ay ano, kami po ni Sir Azurin ay magtutulungan po sa Deputy Chief of Police po para po sa maintenance po or maintenance at ma-improve po natin yung ating peace and order po dito sa Lipa City. Ang maganda nga po nito, medyo mas familiar na po ako sa ano dito sa Lipa City. Kaya po mas play ko po, mas magiging mas yung tandem po namin ni Sir Azurin ay magiging mas effective po gawa po ng aming pagtutulungan. At syempre po, inaasahan po namin ang assistance din po o pakikipagtulungan ng ating barangay at ng ating LGU po. Yun lang po at magandang umaga po sa ating lahat.
Thank you, sir.
Maraming salamat po, Major. At sana po ay maging... makabuluhan din ang inyong pagdating dito sa amin sa Lungsod ng Lipa. At alam ko sa inyong pakipagtulungan pareho ay nasa magandang mga kamay ang Lungsod ng Lipa. Maraming salamat po muli sa inyong lahat at sana po ay makita-kita po tayo sa Bandarian.
Thank you po, sir. And we are looking forward po sa magandang samahan ng PNP and lagi naman po nakasupport ang Sangguniang Panglungsod sa programs po for peace and order. Thank you so much po and God bless and ingat po.
Thank you, Kayang.
Honorable Spy Toledo, you are recognized.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Good morning to the August body and to our guests dito po sa ating Sangguniang Panglungsod Session Hall. Madam Chair, nandito po ang ating mga bisita mula po sa Junior Chamber International Lipa and ang atin pong isa sa 10 Outstanding Young Men of the Philippines or TOYM 2021 nominee and winner na si Mr. Aristelo Asilo po. Madam Chair, nais ko rin pong kunin ang pagkakataon bago po natin igawad ang resolusyon na nire-recognize po natin ang JCI Lipa at si Mr. Asilo sa pagkapanalo sa TOYM. Nais ko po munang anyayahan at imbitahan si President Bea Robles upang mabigyan po tayo ng background patungkol po kay Mr. Asilo at kung bakit po merong JCI Lipa na nag-e-exist at nag-e-endorso ng mga mamamayan or candidates para maging kalahok sa TOYM. At pagkatapos po ni Pangulong Bea Robles, ay susunod naman po si Mr. Aristelo Asilo upang makapagbigay din po ng kanyang maikling pananalita at pasasalamat at pagpapakilala po sa ating lahat. Maraming salamat po, Pangulong Bea Robles. Ginagamit ko po ang wikang Filipino dahil ngayon po ay August.
Still suspended.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you so much to Vice Mayor Camille and all the city councilors of Lipa for inviting us today and recognizing our very own TOYM awardee, Aristello Asilo. He was actually awarded the TOYM honoree for social entrepreneurship. And for everyone's information, those who are not very familiar with JCI, JCI Lipa is a leadership organization that not only trains members, but also other stakeholders as well. We are also heavily involved in community action. And also, JCI Lipa, for everyone's information, is the second largest chapter in the Philippines with 114 members. One of the things we do is actively look for outstanding citizens who go above and beyond in creating positive change. So JCI Lipa was fortunate to have nominated and been awarded two people from this very city. The first one is Ms. Isa Mejeno, and the second one is Aristello Asilo. So we're actually still on the lookout for our next TOYM honoree. So if anyone has any suggestions, please do let us know. Anyone from you may approach anyone from our chapter. So again, thank you for having us today.
Thank you po, President Bea. Next po si Mr. Aristello Asilo.
Magandang umaga po, Vice Mayor Lopez, sa mga miyembro po ng Sangguniang Panlungsod, guests, and everyone po dito sa hall. Magandang umaga po. Una-una po, salamat sa inyong pong recognition. Like 25 years ago, it was my first time in Lipa as a sweepstakes ticket vendor. I was with my lola. Nagtitinda kami ng sweepstakes ticket sa bayan ng Lipa. 8 years old ata ako noon. And then, tuwing piyesta, pumunta kami dito sa Lipa para magtinda ng sweepstakes ticket. And then, later on, after like, nung pagka-graduate ko ng college, nagpunta ako rito sa City Hall, first time kung pumunta ng City Hall. At tapos, napaaga ang dating ko, it was like 6 a.m. At ang unang-unang dumating nung tanong si Mr. Lijo Lopez. Lumapit siya at sabi niya sa akin, anong kailangan mo dito sa City Hall? So sabi ko, gusto ko lang pong dumaan kasi naalala ko nung ako yung natin na ng sweepstakes ticket dito sa Lipa. That was many years ago. And then last 2008, I had a lift update. From UP Los Baños, I transferred to Lipa to work at De La Salle Lipa. Looking back, I thought that it would be nice to give to the community, especially in Batangas. So I had my first work here. And then I had now my business on coffee together with my two partners, Katine and Alan, who are over there. So I had that work with them. So we're now doing work for the coffee industry, not only in Batangas, but in the entire Philippines. I always tell that the TOYM means a lot to us because TOYM is more than an award. It's for the unsung, the untapped, and the unvalued. And then I am very thankful to JCI Lipa, now headed by Presbyter Robles, because they have been here for like more than 50 years and they've been doing a lot to the community. There are so many young men and women doing lots of activities who are not yung tahimik lang sila. No, a lot of them are over there. And maraming mga kabataan ang may mga dreams. May mga kabataan o may mga gustong gawin sa Batangas. If you go to the many further communities, maririnig nyo yung mga adhikain nila, yung kanilang mga pangarap na gustong gawin. And many of you here at this esteemed Sangguniang Panlungsod Hall are very supportive of these people. And like me, who have had a leap of faith many years ago, you are one of the reasons why we are here. You are also one of the inspirations why we are doing this. Because it is in service and volunteerism that we are inspired and motivated to do a lot of things. So I hope you will continue to support youth groups, youths who have dreams, youths who are supportive of the Sangguniang like JCI Lipa and many other organizations here in Batangas. Again, I thank you so much from the bottom of my heart and have a good day. Thank you. And thank you also, Consejal Spy, for that. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Asilo and President Robles. Resolution number 286, resolution recognizing Junior Chamber International JCI Lipa and its nominee Mr. Aristilo Asilo for being honored as one of the 10 outstanding young men of the Philippines TOYM 2021. May I please request all the SB members and our Vice Mayor to present the certificate of recognition to JCI Lipa, who is a member of a civil society organization of Lipa, and to Mr. Aristilo Asilo as a recognized of congratulatory to both of them po. So thank you very much.
Session resumed. We now go to our privilege hour. Attorney Gali Angeles, you are recognized.
Thank you, Madam Chair, and good morning to our colleagues. Meron lang po akong privilege speech regarding po ito sa, kasi nagpasokan na po ulit, ano, there are reports that reached to my, that had come to my office about the purchases of, ano, yung mga sapatos. Ito po ay talagang kalat na rin, and several of them have already came to my office to bring about their concerns. Ito pong mga ating mga kababayan na ang mga anak ay nag-aral, nag-enroll, bumili ng sapatos sa palengke. Hindi ko na po sasabihin kung anong department store yan. Ay sinuot, hindi pa nakakarating ng bahay, ay tagtag na ang suwelas. Bigtal na. Eh, alam naman po natin, meron tayong Consumer Protection Act kung saan po, at maging sa civil code natin, meron tayong warranty against eviction. Kung saan, pag kayo po'y bumili na isang bagay gaya ng sapatos, ito po'y may garantiya ang nagbenta sa inyo na ito'y tatagal at hindi masisira sa loob ng 6 na buwan. Kung hindi, ito po'y pwedeng isauli. At as a matter of fact, the policy of no return, no exchange, or no refund is not allowed. Ano? Bawal po yan. At may karampata pong kautusan ng DTI na sila po ibibigyan ng penalty up to 300,000 pesos. So with this, Madam Chair, I'd like to bring about the concerns of our poor citizens who have mistakenly bought from this department store, and also to investigate and whether or not our sellers and suppliers in our public market and some other business institution have been complying with the Consumer Protection Act. So with this, I respectfully move that this incident be referred to the appropriate committee for proper investigation as well as coming up with the ordinances to prevent this from happening again. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Thank you, Attorney Gali. Matter brought up is referred to the Committee on Trade and Industry. Honorable of your Rocafort, you are recognized.
Madam Chair, may I request the Honorable Attorney Gali Angeles for some clarification only. For purposes of discussion in the committee hearing to be conducted by the committee, Madam Chair, may we now know the name of the establishments being identified by Attorney Gali regarding para po sa pagbibigay ng invitation, Madam Chair.
And well, there are some unverified reports, but I still have to confirm. But according to the reports, it's from New Star, ano ba yan? Store or something like that. I'm not familiar with that, but according to some reports, they bought it from New Star.
And Madam Chair, it is important also to know how much is the shoes na ibinenta. Kasi ho, syempre, para lang ho na ilagay natin sa record na madiscuss.
Yung iba po ay nag-range from, yung po nag-report sa akin, 500 pesos at saka meron doon pong 400 pesos.
Sige, mahal
peso
na rin
shoes. Oo, manamamahala na po sila doon actually. Kaya they're expecting something more from that item.
Thank you, Honorable Merla Silva. Privilege.
Uh-huh. Sana itatanong ko, itatanong ni Kinsalab Yor, at maganda ho yun. At sinabi ho ni Kinsal Gali kung ano ho pangalan ng establishment para ho yung ating mga kababayan maalarma na doon ho ay mga fake ang sapatos. dapat sa Salora, no, nabili, para walang fake. Thank you, Madam Chair. I have two letters from the, one from the Honorable Mayor, City, Eric Africa, regarding the request of Barangay Captain Berilio Nestor Mendoza and Marcela Mendoza regarding the request for the reclassification of their property with an area of 703, 344, 264, 318, and the other one is 799, located at Barangay Claridel, Lipa City. They are requesting for the reclassification of this property. So, Madam Chair, I am requesting the Chair to refer it to the proper committee for proper action.
Refer to the Committee on Land Use. Any other privilege?
And one more thing, Madam Chair, mamaya. There's a letter from ex-Barangay Captain Milencio Cuenca. Ito ay sulat sa atin ho, na ipararating ho sa Sangguniang, na kung saan ho ay sinasabi ho ng sulat na ito na siya ho ay may pag-aari na 1,114 square meter na ang nangyari po ay naging karsada. Without his knowledge, ay ito ho ay ginagamit na po yung kanyang property at ang hinihingi nga ho niya, ito ay mabayaran ng ating pamahalaan na sa ganun ho ay maging legal na ang paggamit ho ng pamahalaan ng nasabi hong kalsada. Kaya Madam Chair, I am request na ito ay
I'm declaring a recess. Session restroom.
So Madam Chair, winiwidro ko na ho yung second topic ng amin ho, privileged speech at huwag na ho yung i-refer sa committee ba? Thank you, Madam Chair.
Noted with thanks, Honorable Merla Silva. Any other, is that a privilege or a question? Privilege. Honorable Aris Makala, you are recognized.
Good morning. Before I start my privilege speech, I would like to congratulate ang bago natin na PCL Secretary General, Kunsihala Denise Manalo. Hello. Sa mga minamahal at iginagalang kong mambabatas sa konseyeng ito, Our Lady Vice Mayor Camille Lopez, sa aking mga kaibigan at mga empleyado, magalang na pagbati po sa inyo lahat. Public toilet facilities and safe drinking water should be a necessity for every Filipino. All kinds of people of any status should have access to these services, particularly those who work, live, and survive on the street. Access to drinking, water supply, and sanitation became a right that this city must guarantee. Madam Presiding Officer, ito po ay buhay na katotohanan na may mga kababayan tayo na pipili mauhaw dahil walang pambili ng tubig. Pipilihing umihi sa kung saan lang dahil walang pambayad sa mga binabayaran na toilet o walang kaalaman o kasanayan na pumasok sa mga malalaking mall upang gumamit ng palikuran. Kung ang pamahalaan ay nakakagastos sa malalaking proyekto tulad ng overpass, why not public communal comfort rooms and drinking fountain sa mga main street o mga particular na daanan na nakakakaraming tao, Madam Presiding Officer. Provide water supplies where common people can drink or refill their bottle plastic container, especially mga tricycle drivers and commuters passing by every day and every hour of the day. As informed by our Metro Lipa Water District Manager, our tap water is safe to drink. Just for the record and information, Madam Presiding Officer, please refer to its proper committee my privilege speech. Thank you very much, Madam.
Matter brought up is referred to the Committee on Public Utilities. Is that a question, Honorable Avia Rocafort? Is the proponent willing to be questioned? Is the proponent willing to be questioned? Yes.
Okay. So.
Pinakakaho ko ngayon ni Consel Aris, Madam Chair. Madam Chair, I would like to ask Consel Aris, para po pagka ito ay kinumiti hearing ng committee on public utilities, ay malaman po natin ano po yung proposal na design ng si comfort room o ng ihian na ilalagay dito sa ating mga
engineering nang bahala dyan, kung sa labior.
Hindi ho, kasi...
Wala na magdi-design yan. I'm not an engineer at design that kind of a building.
Hindi ho, kasi Madam Chair, before there are programs and projects na nagtayo tayo ng mga CR. Itong mga CR na ito ay basta na itinayo ng mga natin. Ano lang, cubicle ihian. So, mapalot ho siya. Kaya nawala na yung purpose ng ihian. So, kaya ho tinatanong natin sa proponent, considering na siya naman ho ang nag-deliver ng privilege speech, para yun yung ipipilit natin na gawin ng engineering office at design na gawin ng engineering office para makapag-identify din sila ng mga lugar na gusto ho nating lagyan.
For this matter, kung sa labior, siguro, kaya nga tayo may departamento ng ihinyero doon, sila nang bahala. I'm not in the proper position, I'm not an engineer, kung ano ang klaseng dapat nilang ilagay.
Okay. Saan ho natin planong ilagay ang mga CR na ito?
Then, kung ano man departamento ang kailangan maghanap noon, sila nang bahala mag-like kung saan nila. Kung tayo may gusto, tingnan natin kung ang isang kunsyal ay may gusto, dini sa harapan ko, o dun sa harapan ni Juan, o dini sa Temcala, o kung saan man. Basta ang akin ay bibigyan natin ng pagkakataon na magkamaroon. Makita ng taong bayan, ah, meron na pala tayo na pampublikong palikuran dito at may mga nakakapag-refill ng tubig dito sa karsada. Ito naman, kasi yung mga nakaraan, yung sinasabi mo, nakakita rin ba ako nun? Kasi ito yung hindi well-maintained, kaya binaboy ng ating mga kababayan din. Pero siguro naman, medyo nakukuha na rin naman ng tao na nahihirapan na rin nga na walang maihian nga. Kung ito'y kasi ay magiging maganda, igagalang din ito ng mga gagamit. Pag ito'y waso, gagamitin din ito ng pawaso. That's yun, Madam Presiding Officer, pagkakakita.
Madam Chair, kaya natin ito'y itinatanong sa bawat nagde-deliver ng privilege speech. Kasi tayo ho ang nag-propose. Pag tayo ho ang nag-propose, ay yun ho yung i-committee hearing ng chairman. Kaya ho itinanong lang natin kung anong design sa ang mga lugar feasible na maglagay ng mga CR at drinking fountain na pinopropose ni Consel Aris. So yun lang po. Sana naman ho ay huwag mamasamain ni Consel Aris.
Okay, hindi ko minamasama. Kasi sa pagkakataong yan, pupunta, ipatawag ang engineering, at magpapadesign tayo, then iaharap ko sa inyo kung ano magugustuhan natin design. They will be the one who will design it, not me.
And at the same time, Madam Chair, the areas na plano nating paglagyan.
Sa area, who's in charge dyan? Siguro, may participation din ang public order dito kasi sila ang pipili kung saan tamang lugar na dapat natin ilagay.
Okay.
Thank you. Thank you, Honorable Merlo Silva. You're recognized. Nyo,
tama, sinusugat, parehong tama. Aking kasi alam niyo, parehong tama naman na what is the intention of the proponent o nitong atin nung Consel Makala. Aking Consel Makala naman, just he brought the idea to the Sangguniang and let the committee conduct a committee hearing. Siguro, parehong maganda ho. Kaya lang, ang Consel Abior, to be sure, ano ho ba talaga ang intention ng atin ho kagalang-galang Honorable Makala? Alam niyo, yung idea ni Consel Makala, maganda. This will be a test sa mga mamamayan na lungsod na Lipa na pairalin po yung tinatawag na disiplina. Dahil ang based on the experience nga ho, may mga nakalagay, kung nyo nakikita, maglagay ho tayo ng bawal umihi. Ay tingnan ho ninyo, siya ho ang mapalot. maglagay ho tayo ng bawal magtapo ng basura. Siya ho ang basurahan. Kaya siguro, this will be a test to the city of Lipa when it comes to the name of discipline.
Thank you. Honorable Avila Rocafort, last comment.
Last comment, Madam Chair, to the Chairman of the Committee on Public Utilities. It is also important to know how do we maintain and sustain the comfort room and the drinking fountain to be established as proposed by Concejal Makala. Because we need budgets, we need for the sustainability of this CR and additional manpower for the CR. Halimbawa ho, halimbawa ho, sa highway, naglagay tayo ng isa. O, saan tayo maglalagay dyan? Sino ang magme-maintain? Paano natin i-maintain? Ilang tao ang ilalagay natin para maglinis niyan? So ito po yung mga considerations. Maganda ho yung programa, pero hindi ho siya ganun kasimple. Yun ho sana ang pag-aaralan ng committee ng public utilities pag tinalakay ang bagay na ito, Madam Chair.
Madam,
thank
amen.
You for the amen. Suggestions, Honorable Avio Rocafort.
Consel Merlo, Consel Avio, yung ibang bayan na hindi kasing unlad natin, meron na may maintain. Lipa pa. That's it.
Madam Chair, yung ibang bayan, iilan lang ang CR nila. May kita natin meron sa...
Ito yung ating...
Santo Tomas, may CR sila sa Palengke. Being maintained by the City Government of Santo Tomas. Yun ho. Titigil na rin ako. Let the committee decide. I just make a suggestion as considerations sa committee kung ano mga dapat pag-aralan, Madam Chair.
Very well noted on your suggestions, Honorable Avio Rocafort. Privilege, yan, Honorable Makala, you are recognized.
May sinabi sa akin si Kunsihala Nicole. Meron na tayong isa sa community park. Yan ha, drinking fountain, CR. Atin natin ang design kung pwede natin yun ang gayanin. That's all, Madam.
Noted. Privilege, Honorable Dr. Loha, you are recognized.
Good morning, Madam Chair, and to my colleagues. Ma'am, ang City Health Office po natin last August 16 ay naka-receive ng email sa Department of Health stating that ang isang Lipa Super Health Center will be constructed in Barangay Marawoy. This will be in exchange of the North District Health Center in Inisluban. They will be transferred dito po sa Marawoy for a bigger health center. And this will be located here at the City Hall compound behind the Animal Bite Center. And it will be funded by the Department of Health with the amount of 6,435,000. Ang isa po kasi sa requirement nila ay isang Sangguniang Panlungsod resolution. So I would like to ask Madam Chair that this be referred to the Committee on Health for the passage of a resolution.
Matter brought up is referred to the Committee on Health.
Another po, Madam Chair, is yung ating weekly update. So as of August 23, 4 p.m., ang active cases natin ng COVID is 211. Ang dengue fever natin as of August 18, kasi ang reporting nila is every Thursday. So the last reported is August 18, 64 cases. Whereas nung August 11, 33 cases. So parang na-double up siya in just 1 week. And latest update po regarding monkeypox, as of yesterday, 4 cases na po dito sa buong Pilipinas. That's all, Madam Chair, and thank you very much.
Thank you for the update, Doc Loha. Any other privilege? We now proceed to the reading of the minutes of the preceding session and approval of the same. Honorable Attorney Gali Angeles, you are recognized.
Thank you, Madam Chair. I respectfully move for the to dispense with the reading of the minutes of the preceding session, minutes of August 10, 2022, and minutes of August 17, 2022, and for the approval of the same.
Any second? Duly seconded by the honorable members of the August body. Discussion, objection, hearing none. The motion is approved.
Thank you, Madam Chair.
Proposed ordinances and resolutions for second reading. Honorable Avior Rocafort, you are recognized.
Madam Chair, I move that we dispense reading of Committee Report on Finance 2022-003, the augmentation of 258,000 for insufficiency of fund for printing and publication under the EBA Tugon program under the special project of the CSWD be adopted, Madam Chair.
Any second? Duly seconded by Honorable Dr. Loho, Honorable Mike Lina. Discussion? Objection? Hearing none, the motion is approved for second reading.
Madam Chair, I move that we dispense reading of Committee Report on Finance 2022-004, the passage of a resolution granting authority of the city to the city mayor to enter into MOA with DOH Calabarzon regarding the national vaccination days amounting to 100,000 as financial aid to the city government of Lipa. I move that the committee report be adopted.
Any second? Seconded by Honorable Spy Toledo, Vinice Manalo, Dr. Loho. Discussion? Objection? Hearing none, the motion is approved for second reading.
Madam Chair, I move that committee report on Finance 2022-005, the request, the resolution request for this August body to grant a resolution of authority to the city mayor to enter into MOA with Water District for the unsettled balance of hospital ng Lipa amounting to 67,191.80 be adopted, Madam Chair.
Any second? Seconded by Honorable Nicole Ronquillo, Vinice Manalo, Mike Lina, Spy Toledo. Discussion? Objection? Hearing none, the motion is approved for second reading. Honorable Dr. Loho, you are recognized.
Madam Chair, I move that we dispense the reading of Committee Report on Health number 2022-004, requesting the August body for the passage of resolution granting the City Mayor of Lipa to enter into a MOA with the Department of Health Regional Office 4A regarding the designation of Clinica Lipa as one of the official DOH primary HIV care clinic treatment hub in the country that facilitates the provision of safe, comprehensive, and compassionate care to PLHIV and the community in general be adopted and approved on second reading.
Any second? Seconded by Honorable Avior Rocafort. Discussion? Objection? Discussion? Honorable Spy Toledo, you are recognized.
Madam Chair, I would like to ask Dr. Loho po kung yung Clinica Lipa and yung St. Aloysius na nagko-conduct din po ng HIV treatment or guidelines doon sa ating patungkol po dito ay meron pa rin pong support na makukuha bukod po sa Clinica Lipa po, Madam Chair.
With regards to St. Aloysius, I'm not really familiar with that clinic. Pero ito pong treatment hub na natin sa Clinica Lipa, this will be comprising the screening, the treatment in general, and not only for HIV, but also for sexually transmitted diseases also. With regard to St. Aloysius, hindi ako familiar kung may nakukuhang support from the Department of Health.
Okay, Madam Chair. Madam Chair would like to add na lang din po kay Dr. Loho. I have nothing against with the committee report for the Clinica Lipa to get a support to the DOH and City of Lipa. I would like to add na lang din po that St. Aloysius is existing dito lang din po sa vicinity ng ating City Hall, dito po sa tabi ng disaster office natin.
Yun ba yung sa social hygiene clinic?
I think, oo.
Baka it's one and the same.
I'm not sure with the St. Aloysius and Clinica Lipa, but it's a different name for me.
Clinica Lipa is located at the social hygiene clinic.
Dito sa likod.
Dito sa likod ng City Hall.
But same with St. Aloysius Clinic.
We renamed kasi po, diba?
Inquire ko na lang po kasi.
So, yun lang, Madam Chair. If I may ask natin ko, Shala,
is St. Aloysius a private organization or?
It's a tawag dito, public
government
or
government.
NGO po natin.
Inquire ko na lang po sa City Health Office.
So, yun lang, Madam Chair. Clarification lang po. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Objection? Hearing none, the motion is approved for second reading. Honorable Avia Rocafort, you are recognized.
Madam Chair, I move that we dispense reading of Committee Report on Traffic 2022-002, the proposed ordinance prohibiting car and motor racing at public roads in the City of Lipa and providing penalties for violation thereof be adopted, Madam Chair.
Any second? Seconded by Honorable Mike Lina. Discussion? Objection? Hearing none,
Madam
the
Chair,
motion is approved.
Ako na lang. I would like to make an amendment with regards to the ordinance kasi hindi po nakasama sa amendment. Under Section 5, kasi it's up to the August body kung sila ipapayag o hindi. Under Section 6, the violator's driver's license. Under this ordinance, the driver's license of a person who participated in illegal drug racing shall not be confiscated. However, failure to pay the corresponding fines and penalties as provided in Section 5 hereof within 15 days from the notice to pay the fine or penalty shall result in the plate number of the motor vehicle to be forwarded to the LTO Lipa for proper action or for the holding of the vehicle's registration. Madam Chair, upon consultation with LTO, sabi po nila, if this is the provision of the ordinance, then kailangan ho nating mag-submit o mag-enter into EMOA with LTO Region 4A para po dito sa implementation ng ating ordinansa na ma-hold nila yung katulad po ng ginagawa ng MMDA na kapag po may violation tayo, lalo na yung mga no-contact apprehension ordinance sa Metro Manila, ay automatic, pag-apply natin ng registration, hindi tayo makakapag-register kasi ho, naka-hold yung ating sasakyan dahil sa violation unless mabayaran natin ito. So ito po yung sinabi ng LTO. So we need to have EMOA. So sabi ng LTO, mas maganda na i-confiscate na lamang ninyo yung driver's license para hindi na pupunta sa LTO, dito na lang sa Lipa, magbabayad sila. So, yun ho sana yung aking amendment na gagawin. Now, it's up to the members kung ano ang mas maganda. Pero I would like to make an amendment na tanggalin na po natin ito, but instead, lagay na lang natin that the driver's license shall be confiscated, Madam Chair.
I'm declaring a recess. Honorable Mike Lina, you are recognized.
Madam Chair, as a member of the committee, with the permission of the Chairman of Committee on Land Use, I move that the reading of the Committee Report on Housing 2022-015 be dispensed with and the same be adopted.
Any second? Seconded by Honorable Dr. Loho Avia Rocafort, Merla Silva, and S.K. Paolo Makala. Discussion? Objection? Hearing none, the motion is approved for second reading. Business for the day, Mr. Secretary.
Just for the day, number one, letter request for letter endorsing the August body, the draft ordinance requiring commercial establishment operating within the city to provide motorists a grace period for the use of parking areas.
Refer to the Committee on Land Use.
Number two, letter request for the passage of resolution granting authority to enter into MOA.
Refer to the Committee on Education.
Three, letter request for an authority to enter into MOA.
Refer to the Committee on Information Technology.
Number four, letter request for the approval of alteration plan, analysis, and alteration plan.
Refer to the Committee on Land Use.
Number five, letter request for an authority to make legal representation for on behalf of the city government on criminal case for Staffa.
referred to the Committee on Good Government.
Number 6, classification request of Marjorie Felix.
Referred to the Committee on Land Use.
7, the classification request of Leonardo Lugos.
Referred to the Committee on Land Use.
8, the classification request of Eduardo Lunar.
Referred to the Committee on Land Use.
9, the classification request of Randy Altamirano.
Referred to the Committee on Land Use.
10, the classification request of Eric Silva.
Referred to the Committee on Land Use.
11, the classification request of Ariel Espiritu.
Referred to the Committee on Land Use.
12, letter request for issuance of SUP.
Referred to the Committee on Land Use.
Number 13, letter request for the review of Barangay Resolutions, Guidelines, and MOA for acquiring multi-purpose rescue bond for appropriate action.
Referred to the Committee on Barangay Affairs. Resolutions and ordinances for the third and final reading. Honorable Rocafort, you are recognized.
Madam Chair, I move that we pass an ordinance realigning the amount of 258,000 to augment the insufficiency of funds of the Poverty Reduction or EBA Tugon Program under the CSWD to be taken from the other maintenance and operating expense account of the Poverty EBA Tugon Program under the same OPS be approved for third and final reading and exempt from the three reading principle.
Any second? Seconded by Honorable Merlo Silva, Dr. Loho, Mike Lina. Discussion? Objection? Hearing none, the motion is approved for third and final reading.
Madam Chair, I move that we pass a resolution granting authority to the City Mayor to enter into a MOA with the Department of Health Center for Health Development, Calabarzon, regarding the National Vaccination Days grant amounting to 100,000. The same be considered as approved for third and final reading and exempt from the three reading principle.
Any second? Seconded by Honorable Merlo Silva, Venice Manalo, Dr. Loho, Mike Lina. Discussion, objection, hearing none, the motion is approved for third and final reading.
Madam Chair, I move that we pass a resolution granting authority to the City Mayor to enter into MOA with Lipa Water District regarding the unsettled balance of hospital ng Lipa amounting to 67,191.80. The same be considered as approved for third and final reading and exempt from the three reading principle.
Any second? Seconded by Honorable Venice Manalo, Merlo Silva, Mike Lina. Discussion? Objection? Hearing none, the motion is approved for third and final reading. Honorable Dr. Loho, you are recognized.
Madam Chair, I move for the passage of a resolution authorizing the City Mayor, Honorable Eric B. Africa, to enter into a memorandum of agreement with DOH Regional Office 4A regarding the designation of Clinica Lipa, previously known as St. Aloysius, as one of the official DOH primary HIV care clinics, treatment hub in the country that facilitates the provision of safe, comprehensive, and compassionate care to persons living with HIV and the community in general, for third and final reading.
Any second? Seconded by Honorable Merlo Silva, Spy Toledo, Venice Manalo, Mike Lina. Discussion, objection, hearing none, the motion is approved for third and final reading. Honorable Rocafort, you are recognized.
Madam Chair, I move that we pass an ordinance entitled An Ordinance Defining Illegal Drug Racing and Prescribing Penalties for Violation Thereof. Wala mga amendment. The same be considered as approved for third and final reading and exempt from the three reading principle.
Any second? Seconded by Honorable Merlo Silva, Honorable Dr. Loho, Honorable Mike Lina. Discussion? Honorable Spy Toledo, you are recognized.
Thank you, Madam Chair. I would like to clarify the ordinance. Section 5, letter D, how much is the penalty for the e-bike and other electric-powered vehicles?
2,000, Madam Chair.
And for the Section 7, impounding of vehicles involved in drag racing, saan po yung impounding property po natin?
Sa CPOS facility, Madam Chair. But considering na ito po ay wala sa ordinansa, pwede pag-amendahan ito? Ay, pwede pong ilagay na lang ito sa IRR, Madam Chair. Okay. Kasi the CPOS naman, under this ordinance, shall draft the IRR 15 days, 30 days, bago po pag naaprubahan ng ordinansang ito, Madam Chair.
And Madam Chair, follow-up question for the impounding property po. What will happen to those vehicles na hindi po makiklaim or hindi po kukunin ng mga may-ari because of other reasons po?
Madam Chair, katulad po ngayon, marami po tayong impounded vehicles. Ito po ay matagal na panahon na. Nagpapagawa lang po tayo ng inventory. So, pag-aaralan po natin kung ito ay pwedeng i-waive natin yung penalty para makuha nila. Magawa tayo ng public notice to a certain period of time. At kung hindi pa rin nila kukuhanin, ay di i-auction po natin.
And Madam Chair, kapag ba na-impound po yung vehicle or yung property vehicle po ng ating mga kababayan, ito po ba ay bukod doon sa penalties
na
meron sila, meron pang additional?
Wala na po.
For how long po pwedeng naka-impound yung kanilang vehicles?
The ordinance that does not make specifics. As long as they paid the penalty and the one who will get the vehicle has a driver's license, a valid driver's license, pwede po niyang kuhanin yung sasakyan. Hindi naman po i-impound ang sasakyan kung ang violator ay may valid driver's license, yung sasakyan niya ay nakarehistro, na ginamit sa pagkakarera, Madam Chair.
Last question, Madam Chair. For example po, yun pong in-impound po nating mga vehicles ay nagkaroon ng sira or na nawala ang ibang parte ng sasakyan. Sino po ang merong jurisdiction or responsibility po dito, Madam Chair?
Madam Chair, it will be under this ordinance again, an IRR shall be drafted by the CPOS, and then we can ask the CPOS to include that in the IRR, and we will review the IRR.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Those questions po ay inaasahan po natin na makita po natin sa IRR with CPOS in this ordinance, in partnership with the PNP and LTO, Madam Chair. Thank you po.
Maganda ho yung huling tanong ni Konsehala. So we will ask CPOS to make an indication yung huling question niya. Wala pa. Kasi pagkatapos na po yung...
Any objection? Hearing none, the motion is approved for third and final reading. Honorable Mike Lina, you are recognized.
Madam Chair, I move for the enactment of ordinance reclassifying the property of Jose Antonio Aguas, married to Maria Teresa Carla Aguas, from agricultural to commercial use.
Any second? Seconded by Honorable Aris Makala, Merlo Silva, Dr. Loho. Objection? Hearing none. Second in motion as well, Attorney Gali Angeles. Any objection? Hearing none, the motion is approved for third and final reading. Ito na yun. Yun na po yun.
Oh, yun na rin yun.
I'm declaring a recess. Session resume. Honorable Mike Lina, you are recognized.
Yes, Madam Chair. It is stated naman sa committee report na kasama ang SUP. So, I move for the passage of a resolution authorizing the city mayor to grant special use permit for the establishment of said recreational facilities and function rooms.
Any second? Seconded by Honorable Merlo Silva, Venice Manalo, Aris Makala. Objection? Hearing none, the motion is approved for third and final reading. Honorable Attorney Gali Angeles, you are recognized.
Any question?
Madam Chair, I respectfully move to declare as urgent item number 5, which is the letter of the author of our Honorable City Mayor Eric B. Africa, for the passage of a resolution authorizing Attorney Wilfredo Rivera, Attorney Carl Mar Al Criston Lipat, and Attorney Rachel Ann Zamora to appear and make legal representation for the pending case on behalf of City of Lipa in the case for estapa filed against Ms. Regine S. Mercado for urgency.
Any second for urgency? Duly seconded by the members. Discussion?
Madam Chair, I'm inhibiting myself in this subject matter, item number 5.
Likewise, I move for the urgency of...
Wait lang. Any objection for urgency? Hearing none, the motion is approved for urgency.
Likewise, I move for the urgency of item number 13, which is the letter of ABC President Emmanuel T. Recto, requesting for the review of Barangay Resolution Guidelines and Memorandum of Agreement for acquiring a multipurpose rescue van for appropriate action.
Any second for urgency? Seconded by Honorable Avio Rocafort and Honorable Nicole Ronquillo, Honorable Dr. Loho. Discussion, objection, hearing none, the motion is approved for urgency.
Likewise, Madam Chair, I move for the passage of a resolution for third and final reading. And also, item number 5 muna ako. Okay. I respectfully move for the passage of resolution for third and final reading authorizing and appointing Attorney Wilfredo S. Rivera, Attorney Lipat, and Attorney Zamora for third and final reading.
Any second? Seconded by Honorable Avio Rocafort, Honorable Aris Makala, Mike Lina, Nicole Ronquillo, Dr. Loho. Objection? Hearing none, the motion is approved for third and final reading.
Last but not the least, I move for the passage of a resolution for third and final reading of the concurrence of the Barangay Resolution regarding the guidelines and memorandum of agreement for the acquisition of multipurpose rescue van for Barangay San Salvador.
Any second? Seconded by Honorable Aris Makala, Nicole Ronquillo, Dr. Loho, Merlo Silva. Objection? Hearing none, the motion is approved for third and final reading.
Thank
Honorable
you,
Abio Rocafort, you are recognized.
Madam Chair, please consider this committee report as urgent of the Committee on Finance 2022-006, considering that we need to make decision on the matter at hand for the utilization of the PhilHealth Fund downloaded to us during the COVID-19 pandemic, dahil hindi po pwedeng matagal na hindi natin ilalabas ang pera. The letter of the City Mayor, Honorable Eric Africa, addressed to the Honorable Members of the Sangguniang Panlungsod, to the City Vice Mayor, Camille Angeline Lopez, endorsing the letter of Dr. Alex Silang in his professional piece based on PhilHealth Chair of LGU Laksa Isolation Facility for appropriate action be considered as urgent, Madam Chair.
Any second for urgency? Seconded by Honorable Mike Lina. Discussion? Honorable Dr. Loho, you are recognized.
Madam Chair, I inhibit myself to the said issue as I've involved during that time as in my capacity as the city administrator during that time.
So, Madam Chair, please put that on record that Dr. Loho, as a member of the Committee on Appropriation, did not sign the committee report because he is inhibiting himself because this particular issue happened during the time of Dr. Loho as city administrator of the city of Lipa.
Noted on that, Dr. Loho.
Madam Chair, I move that we pass a resolution endorsing to the city mayor the utilization of the professional piece based on the PhilHealth Chair of LGU Laksa Isolation Facility for appropriate action. The same be considered as approved for third and final reading, same of the reading principle. Attached is the computation of the suggested computation of the professional piece of those who will utilize the said fund, Madam Chair. The same be considered as approved for third and final reading and exempt from the three reading principle.
Any second? Seconded by Honorable Aris Makala, Merlo Silva. Objection? Hearing none, the motion is approved for third and final reading. Honorable Paolo Makala, you are recognized.
Madam Chair, I would like for the urgency of this subject matter of business for the day, item number 3, letter of the city mayor, Honorable Eric Africa, addressed to the Honorable Sangguniang members through Vice Mayor Honorable Camille Angeline Lopez, requesting the August body for a passage of a resolution granting authority to the between DICT po and the Madam Chair, DICT and Lipa LGU for a memorandum of understanding. For urgency, Madam Chair.
Any second for urgency? Seconded by Honorable Merlo Silva, Dr. Loho, Aris Makala, Mike Lina. Discussion? Honorable Spy Toledo, you are recognized.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Nakalagay po sa MOU natin, one of the responsibility ng LGU ay classroom, laboratories, training venues, computer hardware with licensed software installed, and other training-related requirements as appropriate. Meron na po ba ang LGU sa mga nabanggit or may availability na po ba sa mga nabanggit na responsibility for the MOU po?
Sa pagkakaalam po natin, yung available po ng LGU ang ifo-focus ng DICT. At ito po ay primary partnership naman po nito ay hindi pangkalahatan. Kung hindi po, ito po ay para sa ICT awareness. Ito po ay kung ano lang yung meron na tayo. Hindi naman po, not necessarily na lahat po ng na naka-include dito ay yun agad ang ating gagawin. At sa palagay ko naman po, ito ay very advantageous sa ating city sapagkat gaya nga po nung nasa ELA natin, tayo po ay hindi pa ganun ka-ready in terms of IT ng ating lungsod. Pero sa pagkakatanong nyo po, ang hindi po lahat sa pagkakaalam ko ay meron ang Lipa City LGU.
So, Madam Chair, does that mean that the LGU will provide those equipments or venues for us to enter into the memorandum of understanding between the DICT and LGU?
Yun po ang pag-uusapan nila through LGU pero ang nakalagay naman po dito ay both parties po
ay ang source of fund nila na paggagamitan ay kung ano pong available between the ICT and the Lipa LGU.
So more likely, Madam Chair, the DICT will provide the funds to pursue the literacy and competency development.
Most probably, meron din pong ambag dito ang City Hall. Pero since ito naman po ay ipinasa ng ating mayor at gustong ipasa, ay most probably po ay mas marami po ang magagaling sa DICT since sa kanila po nanggaling yung proposal din.
And one of the section na nabasa ko po sa MOU natin ay kung ano man po yung magiging gamit dito po sa training na ito ay magiging pagmamay-ari na po jointly ng DICT and LGU. So, Madam Chair, one last question. Saan po pagaganapin itong literacy and competency development training?
Wala pong nakalagay pa since ito po ay understanding pa lamang. At, pero sa tingin ko po, ito po ay sa Lipa City. At kung meron man po ng outside ng premises ng Lipa, ay sa tingin ko, ito naman po ay may kaakibat na pondo. At gaya nga po nung nandun sa clause nila na ang availability naman po ng funds ay kung may available po sa City Hall, ay wala pong problema. At kung meron naman pong libre na ibibigay or mga freebies galing sa DICT ay kanila rin pong itong ibibigay sa mga ite-train po dito po sa LG sa ating LGU.
Okay, Madam Chair, I would just like to emphasize the responsibility of the LGU when it comes to classroom, laboratories, training venues, computer hardware with licensed software installed and other training related requirements as appropriate doon po sa training na to para hindi naman po masayang as we move forward to our better information technology system here at the LGU. And I support Councilor Paolo Macala for the approval and his motion for the memorandum of understanding between the ICT and LGU Lipa, Madam Chair. Thank you.
Thank you, Madam Chair.
Any objection? The motion is approved for urgency.
Likewise, Madam Chair, I move for the passage of a resolution granting authority to the city mayor of Lipa to enter to a MOU with Department of Information and Communications Technology for the implementation of ICT-related training courses and capacity-building activities for third and final reading and be exempted from the three reading principles.
Any second? Seconded by Honorable Merlo Silva, Spy Toledo, Dr. Loho. Objection? Hearing none, the motion is approved for third and final reading.
Thank you, Madam Chair.
Honorable Merlo Silva, you are recognized.
Urgency na. Madam Chair, with regard to my privileges speech a while ago, regarding the letter from the letter of the mayor addressed to the Sangguniang regarding the request of spouses Perillo Nestor Mendoza and Marcelo Mendoza for their property located at Barangay Plaridel, requesting for the reclassification. So, Madam Chair, I move that these matters be considered as urgent. And also, I am asking the permission of the chairman and members of this committee to let me be the one who sponsored this matter.
Any second for urgency? Seconded by Honorable Avio Rocafort, Honorable Aris Macala. Discussion, objection, hearing none, the motion is approved for urgency.
So, Madam Chair, I move for the passage of an ordinance reclassifying the property of Berilio Nestor Mendoza and Marcelo Mendoza located at Barangay Plaridel with an area of 703 square meters from agricultural use to residential use for third and final reading.
Any second? Seconded by Honorable Aris Macala, Honorable Avio Rocafort, Honorable Dr. Percival Loho. Objection? Hearing none, the motion is approved for third and final reading.
Likewise, Madam Chair, I move for the passage of an ordinance classifying the property of the same person, requesting for the agricultural use to residential use with their property with an area of 344 square meters located at Barangay Plaridel, 4th and final reading.
Diba? Tapos na.
Hindi, lima rin. Lima. Hindi pwedeng sa isa.
Any second? Seconded by Honorable Aris Makala. Any objection? Hearing none, the motion is approved for third and final reading.
I move for the passage of an ordinance reclassifying the property of spouses Berhilio Nestor Mendoza and Marcela Mendoza for the reclassification of their property from agricultural use to residential use with an area up to 64 square meters located at Barangay Plaridel, for third and final reading.
Any second? Seconded by Honorable Mike Lina, Aris Makala, Dr. Loho. Objection? Hearing none, the motion is approved for third and final reading.
Last two. I move for the passage of an ordinance reclassifying the property of Berilio Nestor Mendoza and Marcela Mendoza of Barangay Plaridel with an area of reclassifying the property of the same person with an area of 380 square meter from agricultural use to residential use for third and final reading.
Any second? Seconded by Honorable Mike Lina, Aris Makala, Dr. Loho, Spy Tulado. Objection? And hearing lastly, none, the motion is approved for third and final reading.
And lastly, Madam Chair, I move for the passage of an ordinance reclassifying the property of Nestor Mendoza and Marcela Mendoza of Barangay Plaridel with an area of 799 square meter from agricultural use to residential use for third and final reading.
Any second? Seconded by Honorable Spy Toledo, Mike Lina, Aris Makala. Objection? Hearing none, the motion is approved for third and final reading. Honorable Attorney Gali Angeles, you are recognized.
I move for the suspension of the rules.
Any second? Rules suspended.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce to you Ms. Elena Rodina. She has a proposal to the local government of Lipa, and I think I will call her to discuss the idea and the proposals that she has for local government of Lipa. Let us all welcome Ms. Elena Rodina.
Good morning to each of you. Thank you for letting me present my ideas to you. So I will try to tell you in a nutshell because, as I told, I have just 5 minutes. Okay, I have even less than 5 minutes right now. So, just 1 second about my experience I have. Okay, I have come from Russia and I'm here already for 8 months. And in my country, I have quite big experience in different social projects. And I was head of a human resources department for a long time in a big international company. So I have quite a lot of things to suggest and I could be very beneficial for you, I guess so. All the suggestions I have, all the projects I have, are based on the analysis that I did, on the analytics that I did while I'm here. And I would call this project The Place. Okay? The Place is quite easy to understand. So it could be one place or different places, and it is for people. Okay, because what I notice here, you have wonderful city and the place is great where it is situated, but some things are missing. And all the ideas coming from Europe, from my country, as well from US. So, for example, I see a lot of you are quite young people, and when you were students, it was quite difficult, I guess, to find a job for you, okay? So what is missing here first is kind of career fairs. It's the place where international big companies or even local companies can give understanding of business for students, where they can present internships for them. It's kind of the first idea. The second idea is workout zones. Do you know what's that, workout? Have you ever heard, just put your hands up? No, okay. So workout is a place where people, it's kind of a gym, but outside, so, outside, okay? It's for free. And it's like better than alcohol and eating food, okay? So it's better to go to gym outside for free because you don't have to spend money. The third thing that is very important, I guess, is we call it lectorium. It's kind of a Latin word, but it means that there is a place where professionals, volunteers, can share their knowledge and give the knowledge to students, to retirees, to young families, to educate them how to be in this life, okay? How to find a job, how to be professional in some sphere. So if you even don't have money to study, you can just get knowledge from this kind of things. So that's why I call it the place. So I suggest to create some places which could be interesting as well for students, for grown-ups, for young families, and of course for retirees, because Lipa is a great city, as I told you, but you don't have such places to just work together, meet together with friends, only cafes and bars. So in a nutshell, these are my ideas, but if you are interested in them, of course I'm ready to just tell you more carefully about each of them. Thank you so much.
Thank you, madam. Any questions? Or your clarifications for madam? Honorable Merlo?
Merlo, you have questions?
Anything?
Yeah. Okay, I think, Elena, this has something to do with our tourism industry. Because it will promote tourists, as you have said, this would be a good place for visiting foreigners, and this would also bring about sustenance of our tourism activities here in Lipa. So we'd like to introduce you out to our committee chairman of tourism. She's a former beauty queen. So maybe you have question, Madam Chair. See? Sa tourism,
hi, good morning.
Hello.
My question is, where are you going to put this idea of yours?
Okay, I have already talked to mayor regarding that, and I saw several places where these ideas could be realized, so it shouldn't be like, you know, one like very big place where you spend millions of dollars, okay? It just could be small places around the town. So just people, like if you want to listen to some professional, you go there. If you want to listen to a concert, for example, you go there. So you just have quite a lot of places here which could be rearranged a little bit with small amount of money.
Is it open for public?
Yeah, for sure. It would be open and most of them will be for free because—
For youth?
Yeah, yes. For youth and for children as well, for school children, yeah.
And you talk about this to our mayor?
Yeah, of course, I did. He suggested me to come here to like share the ideas with you. Yeah.
Okay, when was that?
On Monday.
Last?
This Monday.
This Monday.
Yeah.
Okay, as the committee chairperson of tourism, if you need help, the Sangguniang Panlungsod or the LGU of Lipa City is always here to help and support for the tourism and for the sustainability of the environment. Thank you.
Thank you a lot.
Thank you for your wonderful proposal, miss. Thank you. Yeah, you can sit now. Yeah. Oh, Honorable Nicole Ronquillo has a question for you.
Good morning, Miss Elena. I just wanted to ask, because I'm not that quite familiar, are you working at an NGO here?
No, I'm not. I'm just individual.
Oh, okay. I actually appreciate what you mentioned about the place. It's because I also have that kind of advocacy wherein it's because I get to travel to other countries.
So
and,
you know, yeah.
I actually see those free workout places like in Singapore, So we actually have here the Lipa City Community Park, and there's this certain play and fitness area. And I was entrusted by our mayor to actually help with the design of it. And well, I hope you could actually check it out as well, because
I saw it.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
Yeah,
there.
I've been there. Yeah.
Thank you. It's because I also tried to incorporate the free workout equipments there so that it can also actually help us with the health of our Lipeños. And I was actually really happy to hear about what you've mentioned, those ideas. It's because it would actually be a good idea to have those kind of places in each barangay. However, I've been really quite struggling in a way. It's because we actually need funds for it. And if I can recall correctly, the city of Lipa was really lucky enough to receive about 17 million pesos for that particular community park. So, so I guess I'm just really sharing how I'm glad that you've actually talked to our mayor as well, so that maybe this idea could finally come into fruition. So thank you so much.
Thank you a lot.
Thank you. Any further questions for Ms. Elena? None. Attorney Gali, you are recognized.
Okay, thank you very much, and we look forward to working with your office. And it's good that the two beautiful lady counselors are going to work with you. And I hope we can come up with a very sustainable program that you have. So thank you very much for gracing our session, and welcome to Lipa. Thank you very much. Resume.
Session resume.
Wala na siguro. I move to adjourn. Announcement.
Honorable Spy Toledo, you are recognized.
Thank you, Vice Camille. Announcement lang po ulit. Last session po na-announce ko na to, but ulitin ko po ulit. Magkakaroon po tayo ng job fair sa August 27, 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. sa Robinson's Place Lipa Activity Area. So sa lahat po ng mga fresh grad at yung mga naghahanap pa po ng trabaho, maaari po kayong magpunta sa Robinson's Place upang makasali po sa ating job fair. Meron pong 7,000 plus na positions na available para po sa ating mga kababayan dito sa Lipa. Ito po ay programang hatid ng ating JCI Lipa, Mayor Eric Africa, and LGU Lipa, ang ating dole at ang ating peso katuwang ang Robinson's Place. So sana po lahat ng ating mga kababayang Lipeño o Batanggenyo na naghahanap ng mga trabaho ay makasali po at magpunta sa Grab a Job Job Fair August 27, 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. sa Robinson's Place Lipa Activity Area. Maraming salamat po.
Thank you, Honorable Spy Toledo.
Announcement lang.
Okay.
Yeah. Announcement, I'd like to invite everyone and all the members of the Sangguniang. We're going to have a discussion later on with the members of the board of the BAC, Bids and Awards Committee of different barangays. I will be lecturing on the bidding process and some of the salient points of the Government Procurement Act or 9184. So I'd like to invite everyone, kung gusto ninyo, so we can discuss. The venue would be the AVR. It's going to start at 1 p.m. yata. So today. Probably you can grace the occasion, and I have invited, most of them are members of the Sangguniang Pambarangay and the treasurer, because they are the secretariat of the Bids and Awards Committee. So if you have time, please be there para naman mabati nyo yung ating mga taga-Sangguniang barangay. Maraming salamat po.
Thank you for the invite, Attorney Gali. Of course, before we end the session, we would like to congratulate our very own, the PCL Secretary General, Honorable Venice Manalo. Congratulations! Can someone motion to adjourn?
Motion to adjourn.
Session adjourned.